Hello dear students and welcome back to this online class video. This is the third part of the fourth chapter, parts and wholes of class 5 subject mathematics. And before starting the video, I request to the all viewers to do like, share and subscribe my channel. Let's start the class. In today's class, we have three topics. So the first is who colors the circle first, it's a game. And the second is guess and check. And the third is colored part. Now come to the first topic. So as you can see here, the name of the first chapter, first topic is game, who colors the circle first. So how to play this game, let me explain this all. Okay, actually this game only four children can play. Okay, then they will make a circle, and that circle they have to divide in 12 equal parts. Okay, as you can see in the picture, that this circle is divided into 12 parts. Now you will write some fraction numbers whose denominator should be only 12. Okay, not more than 12. Like here you can see that 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, 1 upon 6. Then here you can see 1 upon 12 and others. So you will write this all in a token. Then you will mix that all token, and the first player will pick out one token, and the written fraction number he will start to color. For example, if he picked up 1 upon 2 token, so quickly he will fill that 1 upon 2 in that whole circle. Similarly, the second player, then the third, then the fourth, they will pick out the tokens and they will start to color as they have number in their token. Okay, so the one who will colored first, he will be the winner. And in this way, this game is played. Now come to the second, the card puzzle. So let's start to read. Look carefully at the picture and get ready to answer 4 questions. Ready? Yes, we are always ready. Now here you can see that a whole square was divided in 4 small squares, A, B, C and D. Okay, and A is also divided in parts. So the first one is in 1/4. B is also divided, the colored part is 1/4, and C is also divided in a colored part, that is also 1/4, and 3/4 are not colored, but the D is blank. Now let's have the first question. Divide the white area in square A into 2 equal parts. Got the answer? Was that easy? Now let's start to do it. So here we have this square A, and the white portion that you can see here, okay, we have to divide in 2 equal parts. So how you will divide? Actually, just from this point, okay, you will draw the straight line to match this line. So here you can see that the whole white part is divided in 1 upon 2 parts. So it was very easy. Now come to the second question. Divide the white area in square B into 3 equal parts. Okay, let's start to divide this. So into 3 equal parts we have to divide. So the first part is colored, so leave that. And we have this white portion. So let's start to divide. Actually, here you can easily get the 3 small squares. So first one you will draw the straight line from here, and the second for here from this line. Okay, now here you can see that the all parts are equal, means 1/3. Clear? Now come to the next question. Divide the white area in square C into 4 equal parts. Okay, is it a bit difficult? Let's see this. So here we have the square C, and this white portion we have to divide in 4 equal parts. So how will we divide? Here we have to divide this whole circle into 4. So how will we divide this? Actually, first you have to get the mid dot points. Okay, like this. Here I am taking the dots. So from this point you have to match this dot points. So let me show you how you will match this all. in this way you can do this. Now another division lines you have to draw like this. So here you got 1, 2, 3, and 4 equal parts, and this all are 1/4 to each other. Yes, it was very difficult, but we did it. Great job, dear students. Now let's take the last question. Divide the white area in square D into 7 equal parts. Okay, we have to divide in 7. So here we have the square D, and we have to divide in 7 equal parts. So it's very easy. Just get the first dot points that are dividing equally to this square. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more 6. I have to take here. So you will use your scale to get the equal distance. Okay, and to draw the straight line, you will also use your scale. So here you can see that in an easy way, I am getting the 7 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, I got 8. So wait. Let me clear this once again. 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and yeah, I got 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes. So similarly, as I have told you, you have to draw all lines using your scale. So just I am trying by my hand, so it may be a little bit not equal to each other. So yeah, finally I got the 7 parts. Now in this way you can solve the all questions. So the last is, the world record for this is 7 seconds. Okay, in 7 seconds, but you can take minutes. Okay, now the next is guess and check. So this is our next topic 2. So start to read this first. At what part of each shape is colored? First guess the answer, then check. So here you can see a tortoise, and its cover is like octagon. Yeah, it's octagon. So you can see that one part is colored, so you can write 1 upon it. Yeah. Now the second one. So one square is colored here. So to get this all, you have to draw the lines first, the division lines that are dividing this whole rectangle. Yeah, it is like dividing in all equal parts. So you can see that total 6 parts we have divided, and 1 is colored, so it is 1/6. Now in the next page, the third one we have. So first we have to draw the division lines that are dividing equally to this whole square. So you can see that it has total 9 equal parts, and 2 are colored. It means it is 2/9. Then the next, in picture 4, we can see that many parts are colored. So first you have to get the square boxes. So now count the all square boxes, means find its area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3. 5, 3, 15. So total 15 parts are there, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are colored. So you can say it is 4/15. Yes, we did it. Now in the next page, do you remember this picture? Yes, it is a 10 gram. Look at the small triangle. Here you can see it is colored. What part of the square is it? How will you find this out? So the question is asking that this colored red triangle part is how much of this square part? So you can easily say that this colored red part is half of this square. Now, next, divide the big triangles and other shapes into small triangles like the red one. How many small triangles are there all together? So the all parts you have to divide by making small triangles like the red one is done there. So next we can take this triangle to dividing this all and draw the lines now to make small triangles. So one I have done here. Yes, then let me take the second one in another way. So you can see, yes, the one triangle is divided in 3 triangles. That should be not equal, that's okay, but you have to make small triangles. Yeah, we have divided this. Now other part, yes, you can take a cross here, then you can, yes, 1, 2, 3 triangles. Yeah, in a simple way you can divide this all shapes in triangles. So in this way we have divided and we got small triangles. Now colored parts. So this is our third topic, colored part. Now the question is complete this. Okay, here we have question number 3 and 4. and how we will complete. So to get this, first we have to check the first and second. So you can see that the whole part is colored into different colors. So this circle is divided into two equal parts. Out of two equal parts, one part is colored. Yes. So here you can see that the complete sentence is now. And the second, here the circle is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can write here 4 equal parts out of, out of 4 equal parts, 2 parts are colored blue. You can see here, and I have filled it. In this way, you can make sentences for question number 3. Here the circle is divided into 6 equal parts, and out of 6 equal parts, 3 parts are blue, or you can write 3 parts are pink or red, you can see. Then the fourth one we have. Once again, you can make sentence for fourth. Here the circle is divided into 4 equal parts, 8 equal parts, and 4 parts are colored in blue. In this way, you can make your sentences. And at last, so we can say that 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 upon, the denominator is not written here, is equal to dash upon 6 and is equal to dash upon 8. So we have to get this. Actually, in the previous video, you have studied about equivalent fractions. So here is an example of equivalent and how to get equivalent fraction. Let me tell you today. So here you can see the first number is 1 upon 2. Okay, so you have to check that what is the relationship between 1 and 2. Means 1 is the numerator and 2 is denominator. So what is the relationship between them? So you can easily say that the denominator is double of the numerator. Okay, means 2 is double of 1. So similarly, this relation you have to get in others. So here you have 1. So its double is 2 to the 4. So here you can write 4. And the denominator in the third fraction is 6. So you have to get its half, means 1 upon 2 relation you have to get in all. So 6 half is 3. And the next question, we have a dash upon it. So once again, you have to get this relation, means 1 upon 2. The numerator should be half of the denominator, and the denominator should be double of the numerator. So here we have 8, so its half is 4. So 4 upon 8. So in this way, you can say that 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 upon 4 upon is equal to 3 upon 6 is equal to 4 upon 8. These all are equivalent fraction. You can take other numbers, for example, 1 upon 3. You can write its equivalent fraction. So can you tell me? Let me tell you. So 1 upon 3. So you can take other numbers if you are writing in numerator 3. Okay, so in the denominator, what number will come? Yes, for that, you have to check the relation between 1 and 3, which is in first fraction. So this is, the denominator is 3 times of the numerator. So similarly, this relation, you have to get in this second fraction number. So it will be 3, 3 ja 9. Okay, okay. Now I am giving you the denominator, that is 12. Okay, and now you will tell me the numerator, what will be its numerator if this all are equivalent. Can you tell me? If you know the answer, write in the comment box. And now, that's all for today's class, my dear students. See you all in the next video. Till then, stay at home, be healthy,